Hello everyone, Professor Franz here, and today we're going to talk about the aggregate supply curve. Aggregate supply curve shows you the real GDP supply at given different price levels, other things being equal. We will talk about the long-run aggregate supply curve and the short-run aggregate supply curve. Here is the difference. In the long run, both the output prices and input prices are flexible. But in the short run, the output prices are flexible, but the input prices are sticky. Here is our long-run aggregate supply curve. It is a vertical line. On the vertical axis, you see the price level. On the horizontal axis, you see the real GDP. So this diagram tells you our long-run output is not affected by the price level, but rather it is a function of labor, capital, human capital, natural resources, and technology. The more of this input, labor, capital, human capital you have, the higher the output. But the output in the long run will not be affected by the price level. Why not? Because all prices are flexible, be it input price or output price. Think about this. Suppose you operate a bakery, and now the price of the cakes and bread you sell has doubled. But the input price has also doubled. So the wage you have to pay and also the price of flour and sugar has also doubled. Well then, even if the price of the bread has doubled, that's not going to encourage you to produce more because input price has also doubled. And therefore, in the long run, your output is not affected by the price level because your input and output price are both flexible.